I'm happy about it.
All right, Coach, congratulations. Thank you. If you could, just how to get this started, just appreciate it.
First of all, we're very pleased to have this opportunity. And even more so pleased to have this opportunity as a winner of the semifinal contest tonight. Feel very blessed to be here. And we'll be able to go out tomorrow and be competitive and represent the SIAC well beyond this point, if that may be the case.
Coming into today's game, what are some of the key points you trust in your players about stopping the runner?
The main thing is stop Higgs. Make sure that we try to contain and not allow her to dominate the game. We knew she was going to be an important player in this role. So we were just trying to make sure that we didn't allow her to do too much. She done much more than we had wanted to, but we were able to contain her athletes.
Was there anything thoughts as far as Sumter's well-being? She sounded last game more rested than everyone else had played here this week.
I thought it was going to be to her disadvantage rather than to her advantage. Being that she sat out and played, I figured that she would be winded since she had trained all week, had played in competition for the entire week. So, and that was the case. She wasn't able to log many minutes because she kept getting tired. So I figured that would be the case. So we paid close attention to her, but we didn't focus our attention on her at all.
How do you keep your team, your players focused on one game at a time? You're coming to the tournament, a big seed, a lot of accolades, all conference players, newcomers of the year, coach of the year, yourself. How do you keep everyone grounded just one day at a time?
Well, it's important to realize the system that we're in and what they've done. They bought into what I've been teaching them all year long, and it's been a process. We didn't initially start this way, but as the season went on, it was much easier to get them to understand how to focus and what to focus on game by game. So now it's like each game is important in and of itself. So that's where most of their concentration and their focus lies. And they've done pretty much everything I've asked them to do with rest, with team meetings, with proper eating. They've done pretty much what I've asked them to do on this trip. So I really wasn't concerned about them focusing beyond today's game.
I think you want to be a good answer. I mean, how do you keep yourself kind of even keel, looking forward to one game at a time? You know, you're looking forward to the championship, you don't want to overlook an opponent, because that can cause some problems there. But, you know, you're looking forward to the championship tomorrow and the tournament after that.
Well, basically, after our game, we sit down and have our meetings, and then everybody goes for the rest, and we focus on the next game, the next task again, and we just go on from there.
But the opponent really doesn't matter to me when you play gotta make sure we take the basketball and we put it in the basket. That's what I'm saying. Tournament time, we got school. So we gotta make sure we do what we're supposed to do. So it really doesn't matter who we play. I don't have a preference, whether it's Tuskegee or whether it's Benedict.